This video, we're going to discuss dimension groups. Dimension groups and dimension structures will cover much more in depth in the reporting and learning section, but I want to give you an overview of it currently. Dimension groups are found within reports module under setup dimension groups. But here you have a list of all the dimensions that can be grouped together. You can see it's most all of the standard dimensions. It is all the standard dimensions. I'll click on job. And we have some defined dimension groups already. What dimension groups do, as you would imagine, is they'll take a group of your particular dimension, in this case, jobs or projects, and lump them into a group that can be used then to filter financial reports, standard reports, most of your reports, some of your custom reports. So if you want to do just want to say general contractor, business entity, just want to see the hotels in a report. You could come here, and instead of having to pull a report for every single hotel and then try and combine it, you create a dimension group for jobs for hotels, give it a name required, so is the ID, description, group type. We'll get more into that, but you can either do specific members or all members, the order, the sort field, how you want to sort it in order. So normally job ID, it doesn't matter. You can play around with that. Max matches is if you want to do like the number of matches for maybe the top 5 or top 10, not used a whole lot in this particular case. So in this case, since all of our job types in this system is populated for all of our projects or jobs, we can filter by job type. You have a list of what you can filter by. It's almost every field in the job project dimension. Set it to an operator of equals. You have multiple operators. And to job type value of hotel. We click save. And then if we come over here to members, it'll show us all the members that are in that category. Of course, in this particular case, as I've noted before, my demo was not set up properly, so I have to click Include Private. So now we see that we have 4 jobs that are hotel types. Now, whenever I go to pull a report, let's say I want to go to General Ledger, and I want to filter this report by my jobs, and I just want to see my hotels. I can come down here, choose hotels, and it'll pull that information. Kind of scared to show it to you here because my data is probably in the child and it's not going to show much. So let's do this then. Let's come down here to my child level where lo and behold, we're in the jobs group, dimension group. And you can see you can also add dimension groups at the child level as well if you want to pull reports from there. However, if you're following best practices, hint, hint, everything will be at top level and you won't have to do this at child level. But at any rate, let's come over to the general ledger. And since it's put in at the top level, that particular dimension group, you will see that it's available down here at the child level. That's why it's good to do it at the top level. It makes all this stuff available at the child level. Now, let's see if I can remember my last data in here. Let's see what we come up with. Let's do current year to date, and we will get into all the settings I'm doing here, so don't freak out. I will show it to you when we get into the reporting module. Show details on activity, and let's click view and let's see if we come up with anything. Ignore that pop-up, and here we go. And as you can see, it's for all the jobs that are hotels. Can I prove that to you? Yes. Let's go to reports, dimension groups, jobs, open my hotels, look at members, include private because I'm at top level. And you'll see we have 20, 01, 5, 6, 22. I'm sure there's a 22 in here somewhere. Now, if I took this off and click view, this may take a bit to pull up. You can see it's now pulled in all of the jobs because I'm no longer filtering it by that group. Now, just a little preview of the reporting section. You could also choose a specific job and pull a report for that, and it'll do that as well. But if that's not what you're looking for all your hotels, you'll need to use the dimension group. Okay? So dimension groups are wonderful. I love dimension groups. I use them all the time. Now, you can do one that has all projects. This is useful if you're trying to create a report that's filtered by other groups as well, not just the jobs group, but maybe department groups. It doesn't hurt to have it. And also, by creating a dimension structure with it, which we'll get to in the next video, you can create different reports with it. In this one, it was done by doing job type, hotel, warehouse, single family. I personally wouldn't have done that. I would have just created, do it by, since it's only going to pull from the jobs anyway, I would come down to status, set it to equals active, or if you didn't want to do that, you could just say, if you want to see even the inactives, in Intacct, if you inactivate a dimension, you can still pull the data. You just wouldn't be able to see it to add new data to. But maybe I want to see all of them and not worry about if it's active or not. Set it to job ID and click is not empty. It will now pull every job that's in the system that it can access. As I told you, if you put something at child level, it's private to that child level. So that's the way to do it. And that's how I would normally do it. There are uses for doing it this way because if later you decide you want to take a job type out, you could, which of course means that the title of your dimension group is no longer accurate, but you could do it that way. And in this case, you know, you say you have commercial, restaurant, single family, warehouse, hotel, you have five types, but only three show them. So I think somebody goofed on this one. Wasn't me though. And that's what dimension groups are for. You can create a dimension group for all of them. You can do locations, you can do department. Locations are good, especially if you want to do reporting on, say, the children of an entity, but you don't want to pull in the entity, or you only do a couple of the children and not all the children under an entity. You create a location group for that, and it pulls in that information. Most dimension structures are built off of dimension group. Well, they're all built off of dimension groups, but you can create them automatically by clicking this little box here and clicking save. But I'm stepping on my next video.